We thank God. He is a wonderful God. He is faithful at all times. He is God who speaks. And every day, we hear Him speaking to us. Hallelujah. Last week, we learned from the Word of God. And Jesus said to us, wounded soldiers, come back to the camp. Hallelujah. Wounded soldiers, come back to the camp. And the whole week, as I was meditating on the Word of God, I couldn't get out of that. That Jesus called for the wounded soldiers to come back to the camp. Now there's something that I know about God. The Word of God says, when His word comes, it does not return to Him without accomplishing the work. Now, as I was meditating, I said, if God calls for the wounded soldiers to come back to the camp, it means there are soldiers that are wounded. He can never call for the wounded if there is no one who's wounded. Now, the word accomplished what it came for. The soldiers are back. They are in the camp. But the soldiers are still wounded. Because wounds do not heal overnight. Now, Jesus called the soldiers back. Those that are wounded. And they are back. But there's still work to be done. Because wounds, depending on how deep the wound is, sometimes they take longer to heal. So in the camp, we thank God that the soldiers are not lost. They are back. But now these soldiers that are in the camp, there are those that are wounded and there are those that are not wounded. Now for these soldiers to be able to still be a great force, they need to know what must happen to those that are wounded and what is the responsibility of those that are not wounded. I couldn't get over this because I know that when wounds are not taken care of, there is a problem. The wound starts to smell and they grow and they are infected. There are a lot of things that happen to wounds that are not taken care of. Now, soldiers, I am confident they are back. We prayed about it. And this God that we serve, He is God who answers prayers. So when we pray and say, Lord, we are wounded, but we don't want to be wanderers. We don't want to be soldiers that are busy with the affairs of the civilians. We want to be back to the camp. He heard us. And we are back. But the problem is, the wounds take time to heal. Now, if you are in a camp that is full of wounded soldiers, you need to know what must be done. We read Galatians chapter 6. And it's still going to be our key scripture today. We're going to read verse 1. Hallelujah. We need to understand that at some point in this camp, there must be no wound. In the camp, we must get to a point where all the soldiers are well and ready to fight. We're going to read verse 1 of Galatians chapter 6. Brethren, if any person is overtaken in misconduct or sin of any sort, you who are spiritual, who are responsive to and controlled by the Spirit, should set him right and restore and reinstate him without any sense of superiority, and with all gentleness, keeping an attentive eye on yourself, lest you should be tempted also. A child of God who falls into sin is not immediately thrown into hell. A child of God who is tempted is not rejected, because as long as they're still alive, they have an opportunity to repent and come back to the Lord. So the soldier might be wounded. And listen to this. A wounded soldier does not cease to be a soldier. He is wounded, but he's still a soldier. So we do not say because you are wounded, then you are no longer a soldier. You are a wounded soldier. Hallelujah. Now, when a soldier is wounded, he is not rejected, because the body is afflicted by the wound, but he still has the skill to fight. That is why I can tell you, you can go to a soldier that is limping, but as a civilian, you cannot overpower him because he is a soldier. Yes, I can see the wound, but the wound is not in an ordinary person. The wound is on the soldier. So he might be wounded, but he can still shoot. Now, when the soldiers are back, they are in the camp. They are wounded. We do not change their status. They remain soldiers. They remain in the army. When we count people that are in the army, we count them because they are soldiers. Now, we're going to talk about three things that must happen to the wounded soldiers that are back in the camp. The theme says, when the wounded soldiers are back in the camp. Not if. The word of God came and all the soldiers that were wandering, that were busy with the affairs of the civilians. Let me tell you this. Civilians, they worry about load shedding. They worry about sanitation.
They worry about shortage of water. Soldiers do not worry about load shedding. They are trained to survive when it's dark and when there is light. So they don't worry about the light. Sometimes it is better when it's dark for a soldier than he's able to attack. So those are not the things that soldiers are worried about. Soldiers are worried about protecting the borders. They are worried about making sure that nothing that is not welcome comes into the country. So if a soldier goes and worry about the things of the civilians, you will hear a soldier talking about load shedding. It's not the problem of a soldier. Now, when the soldier is back in the camp, the Bible says, number one, those of you who are responsive to and are controlled by the Spirit, three things must happen. You must set him right. Number one, the soldiers must be set right. What does it mean? The wounds must be treated. Hallelujah. The wounds must be treated. You who are responsible for that, you must make sure that you clean the wound. You make sure that you dress the wound. Make sure that this wound is treated. But when you are treating the wound, be careful. That is why when you start to work on somebody's wound, you put on gloves. You make sure that you are protected. When you are busy, be careful that you are not also tempted. Now, this is a situation. This soldier was wounded by gossip. People spoke so much about her, and she thought this is not going to work, and she went away and started to do things. He went away and started to do things. Then Jesus says, hey, you are a soldier. They gossiped about you, but you are a soldier. They said you are useless, but you are a soldier. Come back to the camp. Now, when he gets to the camp, when she gets to the camp, you who respond to the case, you must be careful, because the problem is you are trying to cover the wound, but you start to gossip as well. You start to talk. So I know. I knew they don't like you anyway. That is why they spoke about you. I knew this church is like that. That is why this and that happened. You are trying to cover the wound, but you are being infected because you are not careful. So when you start to do, the Bible says you must be gentle. You must be gentle. Because you are not helping. When you say, I knew they don't like you anyway. The Bible says you must be gentle. We know that when this man was out as a soldier wounded, he did a lot of things. So when he comes back, he does not need you to tell him that he was weak. He doesn't need you to tell him that the reason why he went away and like that and this happened is because he doesn't pray. He needs you to tell him that Jesus loves you. This wound is going to heal. And you're going to stand again. It was painful. You know, when Jesus speaks sometimes, he tells us the truth that is painful. He said, hurting people, they hurt. It was painful to me to hear that Christianity, we are the only religion that we shoot each other and expect to win the war. Now, when we read in the Word of God, in the book of Romans chapter 11 verse 29, it says, for God's gifts and his call are irrevocable. He never withdraws them when once they are given. And he does not change his mind about those to whom he gives his grace or to whom he sends his call. Now listen to this. When you are a soldier that is wounded, your skill is not taken away. When you are a child of God who fall into sin, God does not withdraw all the gifts that were given unto you, because he knows that when you repent, you will still need to operate. You will still need to work. You are still a soldier. Now the word of God says in 1 Corinthians 16:14, let everything you do be done in love. True love to God and men is inspired by God's love for us. Now, when we are treating each other in the camp, regardless of where the wound is, sometimes the wound is at the back because the soldier was running. But now that the soldier is back in the camp, he must be treated with love. Love must prevail in the house of the Lord. We must correct each other with love. We guide each other with love, because we are in the same army. So when we are treating the wounds, when we are setting the soldiers right, that must be done with love. Now the soldier that is being treated, the word of God says in James 4:10, humble yourself in the presence of the Lord, and he will exalt you. Humble yourself by the side of the Lord, he will lift you up. Now, the problem with soldiers that are wounded is that they will tell you, when you are trying to fix them, they ask you, do you know me? Do you know who I am? Do you know how long I've been in the church? Do you know how many messages I've preached in my lifetime? Yes, soldier, we know that, but at the moment, you are wounded. You cannot tell me anything. I can open for you scriptures. Listen, even if the wound is here, even if I can put on a jacket, the wound is still there. Now, scriptures are not there to hide the wound. They are there to heal the wound. Now, if you take the scripture and try to hide the wound with it, the wound will remain. Soldiers are back in the camp, but they must be humble and allow. There are counselors in the house of God. I know they are not as qualified as you are. I know they don't have as many degrees as you have.
But at the moment, you need to go to them and receive the counseling so that the wound will heal. I know when you were driving to church, you saw the same counselor running. It's not about your status. It's about what's happening now. There is a wound that must be treated. Be humble. I know. You know a lot of scriptures, many verses. You know them, and it's very good. But at the moment, let's deal with the wound, soldier. You were in the army for a very long time. We know you received a lot of medals in the army. We accept that. But you are wounded. The problem is when we receive counseling as children of God, instead of listening to the counsel of God so that the wounds may heal, we want to preach. Yes, you are a preacher, but now you came to receive counsel. Keep quiet and listen. I'm trying to imagine what would happen if a doctor is sick and he has to go to another doctor. When a doctor is sick and he goes to another doctor, when he arrives in those rooms, he doesn't arrive as a doctor, he arrives as a patient, and a patient must be treated by the doctor. The problem is that wounded soldiers can be too proud. And they don't want to listen to anything. They don't want to hear anyone. Pride is dangerous. Instead of the wound in the leg being treated, if you are proud, you will end up losing the whole leg. Number two, the wounded soldiers that are back in the camp, when the wound has been treated and the wound is healed, they must be restored. Now, this is the restoration. It doesn't mean that immediately, when the wound is healed, you must run and go into the battlefield. When you were lying down because of the wound, by the time when you were wounded, you lost a lot of blood. You lost a lot of virtue. You lost a lot of power. Now you need to go back into training so that you can regain the strength. So when somebody has fallen, and they had fallen, when the wound is healed, you don't run to preaching to others. You run to feeding with the word so that you regain the strength. How can you strengthen others when you are not strengthened? So
So the wound is healed, we know. But now you need to regain the strength. Look, Timothy, we know. You are a soldier. But you were wounded. Now when you were wounded, you lost blood. Now you need to be treated and you need to heal. When you have healed, sit down and learn. Sit down and eat and exercise so that you regain the strength. The weapons that we carry, they are heavy. They need you to be strong. That is why the word of God says, be strong in the Lord. We need to be strong. You see, there's a problem with experience, more especially when it comes to teaching and preaching. Because sometimes we end up being delivery vans. We end up being delivery vans. A delivery van does not eat bread. You didn't hear that. Every day, bread is loaded in the van and it's secured and it's taken to shops, but the van does not eat bread. Now, if a minister or a child of God is a delivery van, he will tell everybody about the good news, but the good news never works for him. He just takes and gives. I once heard one preacher saying, when I go into the word of God, I don't go to the word of God so that I can get a message and preach to you. I go to the word of God so that I can eat. What you get are leftovers. I have already eaten. I remember one day, the man of God says, Jesus said through him, a preacher must not forget what the preacher has preached. If a preacher preaches and he forgets, that day he was a delivery van. He delivered the goods, but he never enjoyed the goods. Now, soldier, you were wounded. You became weak in the process. It is time for you to eat. Don't worry about others. The soldiers, other soldiers are there who are not, they are busy with feeding others. Now be fed. There are people who don't want to be told anything. And it, you know, we end up lying. The man of God comes. Jesus has put a message that he must speak to us. And when he speaks to us, when he finishes, I go to him. You know, man of God, what you just said, you know, I just heard everything, you know, when you were preaching, you know, you were just confirming. He was not confirming. He was saying what God is saying to you. Don't try to rub it off. Take it in. Have you ever been in a class and there is a learner in the class who doesn't know something? When the teacher goes to him and say, 2 + 2, you'll hear the boy say, teacher, that is so easy. Why don't you ask these ones? you can't ask me that. That is an easy one. What is 2 + 2? He does not know, but he doesn't want people to know that he does not know. So he tries to shift it. That's what happens to us. We say, oh, I knew that, you know. I don't know why I went to church today. Because they preach the things that I already know. You are lying. You do not know. Sit down and listen so that you can be strong. You think Jesus is stupid? He can bring people together and say nothing. The soldier is wounded. When he gets where people are, he tries to be strong and walk right. You are limping. You need to be able to be fixed. How will you be fixed if you are hiding? We need to learn to hear God. When he speaks, so that we can grow and be restored to our normal position. You know, when now you are restored and you are jumping around, people will say, but where was this wound? Was it the left or the right? They won't even know anymore because you are fully restored. They mustn't say, but it's like your left leg is still painful. We are here for Jesus. When he sees that we need to be bandaged and to be fixed and to be set right, let's allow him. Just allow him to touch you. You will never be the same again. Just allow him to touch you. You will never be the same again. If you want to limp for life, resist restoration. But if you want to stand again, allow him to touch you. The last one, number three. Let's read this verse. Psalm 51. Verse number 12 says, restore to me the joy of your salvation and uphold me with a willing spirit. Let's not read this chapter too fast so that we can quickly finish it. David says, restore to me. I need this restoration. I need you to uphold me. Second Corinthians 13 verse 9. Finally, brothers and sisters, rejoice. Strive for full restoration. Encourage one another. Be of one mind, live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Praise be to Jesus. And the last one. Now the soldier must be reinstated. A soldier that is fully restored, the soldier that is fit for battle, must be fully restored back to war. Hallelujah. Now, if you want to be reinstated while you are still limping, you are going to cost us. Now, when the time comes and when you are fully restored and it's time to be reinstated, Ephesians 6:11 says, put on the whole armor of God. The armor of a heavy armed soldier which God supplies, that you may be able to successfully to stand up against all the strategies and the deceits of the devil.
When you are reinstated, you put on the full armor of God. And you will be able to stand against whatever brings. Now, this is what happens with the soldier that was wounded. When he's back in the field, he is more dangerous than ever. The soldier that was once wounded will never make the same mistake that he made in the beginning that got him wounded. So the soldier that is reinstated is dangerous. You know why? The enemy knows that this soldier was wounded, so he thinks the soldier is still limping, and he comes like he's going to wipe you away, but he finds you that you are fully armed and dangerous. When we allow the process of God to happen in our lives, the devil is in trouble, because we come back and we are ready for all the strategies that he can bring. When the soldiers are back in the camp, they must allow God to deal with them. And when God is done with them, they are more dangerous than ever. You see, the devil thought you were weak. That when you see women, you just melt. But now he didn't know that you went back to the camp and you were set right. You were restored and you were reinstated. When he throws the women with seduction spirits, instead of you being seduced, you cast the spirit out, because you are more dangerous than you were. So whatever the devil wants to trap you with, it will trap his own mother if he has one, because you are reinstated and you are more powerful. Children of God, Soldiers in the house, we know that sometimes we fall, but we must make sure that we do not remain on the floor. We do not remain in the ground. We must stand up and allow God to work with us, to deal with us. Sometimes it's painful. Have you ever seen somebody who's being stitched? It hurts when you are being stitched. It hurts. The process of those stitches to heal, it is painful. But when you are fine, you are more dangerous than ever before. Soldiers are not thrown away because they are wounded. They are treated. They are restored. They are reinstated. And they are back in the battle. The Bible says, so that you may be able to stand against all, not some strategies, but against all. Whatever the devil brings, you will be able to stand. You know, sometimes you were wounded because you didn't have the breastplate. But when you are reinstated, now you don't leave others out. You put on the full armor. There is no way that the devil can attack. You are fully armed. Soldiers, there are those of us who are saying, but I'm not wounded. These ones were wounded because they are weak. Be careful. Be careful. Be careful. I know that you are talking like that because you think you are holier. And all of them are sinners. Be careful. If you are a soldier that's mingling around, talking about things that do not concern you, be careful.
Be careful. Soldiers are back in the camp. The process of healing must never be disturbed by anything. That is why Jesus says, when he tells you 3 days of deliverance, you cannot alter it to suit you. It must be 3 days of deliverance, because he knows how deep the wound is.